Welcome to all of our delegates here today. I'm Fiona Lang-Sharp, IBCLC, Director of Communications and MC here at GOLD Learning. Well, it's great to be here today. Very excited to be sitting down talking about our GOLD Obstetrics Conference here again. And today we have very special guest, Dr. Jeff Denney is with us here today. He's going to be speaking at our upcoming GOLD Conference. And of course, I want to make sure that you have all the details on our GOLD Obstetric Conference. You can go to the website right now, goldobstetrics.com, to check out all the details. Don't forget that we have our opening and closing keynote, which is absolutely free for everybody to come and view as well. Well, welcome, Jeff. It's great to have you here today.
Delighted to be here. Thank you for having me.
So, Jeff, we definitely want to get to know a little bit about you and where you are in the world. So why don't you go ahead and just tell folks where you are and sort of what practice looks like for you today?
Absolutely. So I'm an associate professor at Wake Forest School of Medicine in the maternal fetal medicine section. Live in Winston-Salem, have three children, and delighted to be a part of this conference.
That's awesome. And of course, Winston-Salem is in where? Which part of the U.S. are you in?
So it's in North Carolina at the sort of the foothills of the Appalachian Mountains.
Beautiful, beautiful. Yeah. So for all of our, of course, all of our folks listening in today from our international audience, Jeff is in that eastern part of the U.S. and it is very beautiful. I've got actually got quite a few friends that live out there in North Carolina. It's a very popular place to live, Jeff. So that's wonderful. So Jeff, tell me, I want to know a little bit about perhaps a little bit about career history. What got you into, obstetrics and those types of things. Tell me, how did it all come about for you? Did you know from early on that this is what you were going to do?
I honestly had no clue. I went through medical school at Medical College of Georgia and set up my obstetrical rotation to get ready for surgery and medicine, and then just happened to try to get as many deliveries in as I possibly could as a student because I thought I'd never be able to deliver a baby again.
Right.
And the residents and attendings all thought, oh, we're going to turn him into an obstetrician. And sure enough, when it came down to sit down and write my personal statement for what I wanted to do, mm-hmm. I got to think it'd be so easy to write it for obstetrics because I really love delivering babies and I like taking care of medical complications of pregnancy. And so it sort of just fell into my lap and made sense to go into doing what I like to do.
That's awesome. Yeah. And now it's become, you're well recognized in your community. I know that you love speaking and, so this was something that just basically came about, but felt like a very natural fit. It sounds to me as well. So that's fantastic. So tell me, what do you do now sort of on that day to day? You're teaching, you're on site. What's happening for you right now?
Yeah, so I'm a part of the School of Medicine at Wake Forest University, and so we have medical students, a very strong residency program in medical school, as well as a maternal fetal medicine fellowship. Mm-hmm. And I think it's one of the better programs in the country, so we have a lot of high-risk obstetrical cases to, mm-hmm. That sort of distilled out for the learners that are there. So they get a lot of very good clinical experience.
Right,
and I give a lot of lectures to the medical school, with a lot of my interest, sort of stem around my research mm-hmm. in maternal fetal medicine fellowship on preeclampsia and the mechanisms of preeclampsia.
Right, absolutely. Yeah, I was going to talk a little bit about the research. So you've been around for a little while now, and what sort of things are you seeing changing in maternal health and research, and even preeclampsia being that's your area? Are we seeing improvements? Are we seeing better research? What's happening?
So a lot of the advances in obstetrical research have been focused on trying to prevent preterm birth, and mm-hmm. certainly we've made some advances in preventing spontaneous preterm deliveries, but lately and clinical investigators and scientists alike have taken an interest in trying to reduce the growing issue of more indicated preterm deliveries. We have mm-hmm. an increasingly older obstetrical population with higher
right.
incidence of medical complications of pregnancy, both diabetes, hypertension, and obesity. And so all these women are at increased risk for hypertensive disorders of pregnancy, mm-hmm. namely preeclampsia and the imitators of preeclampsia.
Right. Yeah, that really leads me right into the next question, is just talking about your actual presentation. Now, this is very cool because you talk about the imitators of preeclampsia. So the full title of your presentation at GOLD Obstetrics is Imitators of Preeclampsia, Manifestations of Endothelial Dysfunction in Context of Hypertensive Disorders of Pregnancy. So tell me, how did you come to want to talk about these things? It sounds very interesting.
Well, as an obstetrician, you're taught to put things into clinical boxes mm-hmm. so that you can kind of sort through and decide how you're going to manage a given condition. But I think when you're talking about preeclampsia and the imitators of preeclampsia, it's really important to think about these disorders as sort of on a spectrum with where there's an underlying dysfunction that they all share of the endothelium.
Right.
And given an individual's sort of predisposition or biological tendencies, they may manifest their preeclamptic or hypertensive disorder in a different manner than another individual. So there's underlying genetic biases as well as underlying medical conditions and organ dysfunction that the patient brings into their pregnancy that lends towards development of these various conditions.
So it sounds like you have to be a very good detective when you're going into these types of scenarios. And so with your group of professionals around you, is that how they sort of see things too? Because it sounds like there could be multiple layers to each patient when you're actually seeing them, and identifying exactly what's going on is going to be really important.
Absolutely. So any one of these disorders can have subtle differences amongst one another, and they're also not mutually exclusive. So someone can have preeclampsia, for example, and then later develop HELLP syndrome, hemolysis, elevated liver enzymes, and low platelets. So just because mm-hmm. they presented with the criteria for preeclampsia doesn't mean they won't develop HELLP syndrome. So we see this a lot in our moms that we are expectantly managing for severe preeclampsia on the antepartum unit in the hospital, mm-hmm. where they've been diagnosed with severe preeclampsia and need to be admitted. And then a week or two later, they may have onset of elevation of their liver enzymes, their platelets start to drop, and then show evidence of hemolysis on their peripheral smear as well. So these conditions can overlap, and they're not mm-hmm. mutually exclusive, and it requires an understanding of the underlying dysfunction that all of them share, which is
right.
that endothelial dysfunction.
Wow. Well, there is certainly a lot going on there. I'm definitely going to be paying attention, listening to your presentation. I'm excited to hear it. And I know the rest of our folks will too. Thank you so much for just taking a few moments just to sort of unravel a few of the things to help us understand how important these different layers can have on, you know, a pregnant woman, and how important it is, of course, to have close follow-up. So it sounds like it's very detailed work for you, Jeff, which is awesome, but I know that you're very passionate about it. So thank you so much for being with us here today.
Thanks so much for having me.
And thank you again to all of our viewers coming in today with us. It's been fabulous having you once again. Don't forget, you can check in on our website for all the times and schedules for this particular conference at goldobstetrics.com. You'll be able to register immediately, of course, for our opening and closing keynote, which will be free for you to view at any time. And of course, register for the full conference as well. I know that you're not going to want to miss out on this particular presentation with Dr. Jeff Denney as well. Thank you so much to all of you joining us here today. Have a wonderful rest of your day, everyone. Bye-bye for now.